Hey Watercolor Wizards, Hajra here. So I share art history, art creation, and instruction in watercolor, gouache, and ink, and I've never posted a video in the past that's anything else because I'm a pretty private, old-fashioned introvert, but today I want to share my unfair Skillshare nightmare because that pretty much describes it, and that my title rhymes is a bonus and one of the few moments of levity that I can insert in this video. Skillshare, some of you might know, is a more recent online platform for teaching tutorials. And don't worry, if you use Skillshare as a student or as a teacher and have a good experience with it, then that's fine. No need to be flaky and distance yourself from me if you're a fellow online teacher and video creator or a student on Skillshare. My opinion and experience with them is not going to somehow damage your relationship with Skillshare. But in my experience, Skillshare has shown a capacity to be contradictory, nonsensical, and unfair, and maybe some of you Skillshare teachers or students won't want to support a platform that randomly lies and disrespects its teachers. I've been told that a few other instructors with a much bigger online presence than me have also had actual gripes with Skillshare, but I don't know the particulars. Anyway, I've uploaded 6 classes to Skillshare in the last year, 3 of them just last month in April, and I had planned another 20-plus classes for this year, but I'm never going to use Skillshare again in the future. Why? Well, here's how it went down. Like I typically do for all my longer videos, I put in a full 40-hour work week of time and energy to paint, film, script, edit, voiceover, etc. for my most recent lengthy Skillshare tutorial. Since I have hypermobility, chronic pain, and injuries, this is an even bigger energy commitment for me than it is for healthier people. Then I published my class on watercolor pencil techniques and demo to Skillshare on Saturday, April 27. The same day, I also promoted my Skillshare class via a YouTube trailer, on Instagram, and also on Patreon with private links for patrons. But a day and a half later, on Monday, April 29, I woke up to find this email in my inbox. For some privacy, all the emails I share will only show the first name and no email addresses. Anyway, this first email inaccurately posited my class wasn't educational, my class didn't contain a project for students to complete, and as a result, my class had been shut down and a strike issued against my Skillshare account. Now, this totally floored me, and everything I'm saying in my defense in this video, I said in several verbose emails to Skillshare, but it didn't get me any closure from them in the end. Anyway, in my first response back to Skillshare for this, I said I felt foolish and upset about having promos up on YouTube, Instagram, and Patreon for a class that had been shut down so hastily. And I asked why they couldn't have just nudged me with a corrective email before striking my account or shutting down my class, which would have been a more moderate response that respected me as a teacher, because I already had 5 previous classes on Skillshare over the past year with no issues. And also I told them that they were just plain wrong in why they actually shut down my class and issued a strike on my account. First, my class was educational. In fact, I was ironically planning on focusing mostly on Skillshare classes for the rest of this year because I was increasingly feeling that YouTube keeps heading, even in the art category, more towards entertainment, public personality-driven, product-sponsored, or product review-based videos. And perhaps my no-frills, info-dense, and technique and art history-heavy videos, which are influenced by my years of being a lecturer at a university, were a better fit for a platform focused on just instruction. And this class was no exception. It was purely educational from start to finish. Second, my class did have a specific project to complete consisting of an exact 7 techniques reference sheet assignment for students and also a goat illustration demo that prompted students to do one of their own. The project details were mentioned and demoed clearly in my video and at length in the text in my project description tab and the class specs on their website, and also there via downloads for my class. So I pointed all of this out, adding that I didn't think that the Skillshare moderator had even watched my class or reviewed the class and project specs, and I also asked to speak to a manager. I'm a blunt and earnest person. I foolishly, I guess, expect logic and reason to prevail. So I thought the Skillshare class shutdown would be fixed pretty fast with an oops, our bad, the way Patreon once fixed flagging one of my children's picture book illustration posts as adult content. In that situation, I sent Patreon an email basically saying, what the heck, and sharing my content and telling them that my content was never adult, and they unflagged my page and emailed me back within a day. I even shared that particular Patreon adult content mishap with Skillshare in another email, saying that when other more professional platforms made errors, they just fixed them, rather than ignoring creators and digging in to avoid apologies. But Skillshare didn't choose to be professional or illogical. I waited for them to respond, all the time super frustrated that my class launch had been sabotaged and I had to eventually make my YouTube promo private and tell my patrons the class wasn't back up. When Skillshare finally responded, their rep totally ignored my emailed proof about the project actually existing and didn't admit that the class closure action was unwarranted. She also ignored my request to converse with a manager. Instead, she wrote an insultingly short response, ignoring my proof about her errors, and bizarrely said, "The class project needs to be in the project description tab as well." Remember that what she said in the first email wasn't that. It was a blanket statement that Skillshare classes have to be educational, as if this was some entertainment video and that I didn't even have a project. This is when things started to get really bizarre. I mean, I had already sent this woman more than one email explaining and showing that my project existed in the video, in the downloads, and yes, also in the description tab as well. And she had ignored all that and not apologized. And now she was randomly fumbling and latching onto a missing description, which again already existed from the launch of my class. So I told her again I wanted to speak to a manager or supervisor because I felt like she was just ignoring my statements. Since I had joined the teacher discussion board that same month regarding publishing one new Skillshare class in April, and this would actually be the third class I was publishing in April, since again I intended on shifting my output to Skillshare, so I was really being an overachiever. So anyway, I thought I could also post a comment on the April class discussion board that was supposedly there for teacher success and support, that the person emailing me thus far had shut down my class totally unfairly and was ignoring my request to speak with a manager. So I posted a comment on the discussion board saying that. As an aside, the Skillshare staff member running that discussion board actually sent me an email last year advising me not to teach how to draw a particular subject or project and focus on techniques that could be applied to various projects instead. So this email from last year is actually contradictory advice to all the fuss and mess about particular projects regarding my recent class, so it's like these people don't even run things by each other, and that's even more maddening. And the laughable thing is, I actually posted classes that fulfilled both these requirements every time. I taught wider techniques and skills and also had specific projects for each class, so all I can assume is these people aren't even watching classes or reading the information text properly, at least not mine. Anyway, a fellow teacher saw my comment on the discussion board meant for this teacher success staff member and commented on it, telling me to hang in there. But that teacher success employee herself couldn't even do that much. In fact, when I checked back the next day, my comment had been deleted by her. This made me feel even more disrespected. I mean, I wasn't a troll. I was a teacher asking for a manager's help regarding one of my April published classes, exactly what I had enrolled in this discussion board for. So I posted a second exhausted comment saying my last comment had just been deleted by her the day before and that my legitimate grievances were being ignored in a totally unprofessional manner and that I realized Skillshare was not a platform I wanted to waste any future classes on. I think maybe because of my second weary comment on that discussion board, which other teachers could see, the next day I finally got an email from a Skillshare manager. She had my older emails and could have directly addressed my grievances. Instead, she made a vague apology for me being upset about routine class moderation. She didn't say, "Sorry, our moderator was wrong and why she shut down your class. We'll try to do better in the future." Instead, she buckled down further and told me she understood why her moderator shut down my class, because I didn't tell students specifically what to do, and that even a sentence of specific instructions would have sufficed to explain my project, and that I didn't have that in my project tab. Except, and this is where I really felt like I was just being gaslighted and going totally nuts. Not only did she ignore all my proof from before, she hadn't even copied and pasted from the project tab to explain how she came to her conclusion. She had copied and pasted from my about tab. So I took screenshots of my about tab text and also my project tab text, which again already existed and was long and detailed, way more than one sentence of project instruction. I even told her she could check with Skillshare's coding department and that there should be a timestamp with no edits proving that my project text had stayed the same since the initial launch of my class. And I pointed out that she'd copied and pasted from the wrong section, the About tab, and not my Project tab. In fact, the project tab even has an automatic second header from Skillshare that says project description. So I stated the obvious again that this 6th class and also my previous 5 classes all logically had their project details and instructions under this project tab. And no past Skillshare representatives had told me that the project tab was, I don't know, actually an April Fool's joke and was for sharing photos of my dinner or pets or ugly Christmas sweaters instead. So hopefully you can understand how this manager and the moderator before her both just repeatedly ignoring that I had done everything to do with the project and project description right and robotically repeating imaginary corrections I had to make was just driving me bonkers. I'll add that I took a look at the Skillshare class info tabs again today, which is about 3 weeks from when I took the project tab screenshots, and the labels have been revised slightly. Now the Your Project tab is called the Project and Resources tab. It's still a separate tab for projects with the same automatic project description header pop-up when you click on it, and I use the same tab all along for all of my 6 classes. But I just wanted to throw it out there that they now call it Project and Resources instead of just Your Project. Because I was feeling so gaslighted, I even went and checked other Skillshare classes, YouTubers who I know and are also posting to Skillshare with far more students than me. And yep, all their project descriptions were in the same project tab I used. I'm not going to show any others here because I don't want any of the Skillshare teachers to feel like I singled them out to support my case in my video, but you can just go see for yourself in my or anybody else's About and Project tabs that they're all used the same way that I use them. So why was this Skillshare manager and her coworker persisting in imaginary, bizarre, inaccurate conditions for me? Why couldn't they just say, oops, we're sorry, your project and project description actually was there all along, in detail, in your video, in your project tab, and also in your download resources? I don't know. So this manager didn't respond again until a week later on May 7th. It was a short final email that once again didn't acknowledge all this horrible fuss over nothing and didn't apologize for her error or her coworker's error regarding my project and project information. Instead, her short email's vibe was just, well, due to all your complaining, we deigned to finally reinstate your class, so why are you still upset? Because it made me waste an entire week emailing you with proof and screenshots that Skillshare never even acknowledged, since owning up to all their contradictions and dragged out inaccuracies would make their actions against my class null and void and totally unprofessional. And because it was super inconsiderate to me as a teacher with 5 classes already on there to look foolish promoting a class I worked so hard on that was shut down for days for totally bogus reasons. So I can't work with these dishonest, unscrupulous wackos ever again. I sent her back an email saying so, and also told her that for what it was worth, I was going to do a video on this in the near future. I guess somehow Skillshare's judgments are supposed to be infallible, but no one's perfect, so that's a horrible principle for any company. Now I just have totally no trust in them. So that was my final communication with Skillshare on May 7th. I waited almost 3 weeks since then, and I'm finally posting this video as they obviously don't care about saying anything further to me, and they never cared about the truth of what I said at any point earlier. My previous 6 Skillshare classes and their private links will still be there for patrons, at least as long as Skillshare deigns to leave my classes up. Sadly, my Skillshare videos are some of my best art instruction videos, filmed with the new camera I got when I launched Patreon and covering grisaille and botanical painting, a watercolor portrait master study, a gouache portrait master study, and 7 ways to use watercolor pencils with an illustration demo all at a leisurely pace. Though I was actually in the right, Skillshare treated me horribly and never owned up to any of their hogwash, and it doesn't escape me that it wouldn't have happened to this extent if I was better at the social media game and schmoozed well or constantly shilled new products or whatever to get a much larger online following. But because I'm an old-fashioned introvert intellectual and without any pretense, I'll probably always have a modest online presence. So to Skillshare representatives, I'm basically invisible and don't get respected like a famous YouTuber or Instagrammer would, even though it's my teaching and painting quality and work ethic that should matter. It just feels laughably corrupt and superficial. I guess that's why I've always been comforted by the saying, the thing about winning the rat race is, you're still a rat. For future longer video tutorials, if I end up doing any more, I'll be sharing private YouTube video links with patrons. I won't make any money off private YouTube videos unlike posting classes to Skillshare, so that's too bad for me as a self-employed artist, but at least I'll have my peace of mind and my dignity. And though I'm going to continue to post weekly on Patreon, I'm probably also going to take a week off of YouTube here and there, just to reground myself, as this whole situation gave me anxiety and burnout, and I don't think I can just keep posting weekly to YouTube from here on out. Thanks so much to those patrons who supported me through this entire Skillshare mess with comments and messages and emails, and also to all my viewers on YouTube who have watched and supported me with views and positive comments for years. Thanks to all of you watercolor wizards for parking your brushes with me and joining me on my online art adventures. You're the ones who made them epic. And however life ends up, that means a lot to me.